This is a testing mic check. I hope you guys can hear me. This is me. It's your good friend, Beethoven, here to compose another song. Thank you.
Yeah, I'm just a Beethoven.
Let's hear it for Dylan. Seat at my table. Let's give one more round of applause for our
mic check. 1 2. Mic check. 1 2. Mic check. 1 2. Mic check. 1 2. Okay, we got mic check done. All right, heading back down.
Mic checks are good.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
We would now like to honor our three seniors that have been a part of the dance team. First up is Blake Tebbs, who is escorted by Sarah Christofferson, assistant coach, who's been a friend since freshman year. She's also escorted by her fiance and her dad. Correction, her fiance and dad wish they could be here with Blake. Blake will earn a degree in biochemistry and business with a pre-health concentration. Blake will get married in May and continue her education at chiropractic school. During her time at Southern Virginia, Blake was freshman and sophomore class president, as well as being captain of the dance team. Let's give it up for Blake. Next up is Dana Riddle, who is escorted by her husband, Devin Riddle, her sister, Cassie Miller, and cousin, Catherine Miller. Dana will earn a degree in business management and leadership with a concentration in publications and plans on pursuing a career in marketing strategy following graduation. Let's give it up for Dana. Last up is Elizabeth Morfonius, who is escorted by teammates Sarah Bunker and Natalie Dixon, as well as her daughter Charity Morfonius. Elizabeth is a four-year member of the team and will earn a degree in family and human development and plans to be a full-time mother and work in prenatal care while her husband is in graduate school. Let's give it up for Elizabeth. We would now like to take this time to honor the three seniors that have been a part of the cheer team. During their time on the team, the seniors have helped the team achieve the following accomplishments during their time as Knights. In 2018, they finished second in the Liberty Classic. In 2019, first place at the CCA Nationals and second in the Stud Group Division. In 2020, second place at the ACDA Reach National Cheer Competition. And in 2021, a first place finish at the ACDA Reach the Beach National Cheer Competition. First in CCA Nationals and first in the Stunt Group Division. First up is Aaron Chadwick. Chadwick is a three-year member of the cheer team and will earn a degree in business and a minor in econ with a heavy math focus. Coach Neely had this to say on Chadwick. Chadwick has consistently been a role model on and off the mat. He has given his teammates the confidence to try new skills. Chadwick encourages his team, works hard in and out of practice, and has been a constant source of strength and determination. We will miss you. Let's give it up for Chadwick. Next up is Tanisha Taylor Bartholomew. Tanisha is a two-year team member and will earn a degree in psychology with a pre-law concentration. T is a wonderful student, friend, and athlete, said Coach Pendleton. She is a cheerleader to so many on and off the field. T is often the first to volunteer and provide assistance to her teammates. She is a thoughtful teammate, and we feel very blessed to have shared in her journey at Southern Virginia University. Thank you for being an example to us all. Let's give it up for Tanisha. Last up is Sawyer Tompkins. Sawyer is a four-year member of the team and will earn a degree in liberal arts. Sawyer is an example of strength, determination, and resilience, said Coach Pendleton. He has unique ability to encourage his teammates to see their own potential and try new things. Sawyer is our hype man and has motivated his team to do their very best in every performance. Let's give it up for Sawyer. Let's give one more round of applause for our cheer seniors.
We'll be right back. Thank you. All right, welcome to all our guests across the country. We're here at Knight Stadium, and you could not script a better day for football. I'm Scotty Winterton, calling the game for you with my ever faithful, handsome companion here in the booth, Greg Gowdy. We just had the kickoff come to the Knights starting out this afternoon. The Knights are hosting the visiting Averett Cougars from Danville, Virginia. You look around out here, Greg, and the trees are on fire. This is about as beautiful it gets here in the foothills of the Blue Ridge Mountains.
This is the best time of the year, Scotty. Once fall hits Virginia, I start singing the ever-classic Christmas song. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
All right. Let's watch. So we have James Pinkston taking the shotgun, Hannah. Hands off to Cade Nelson. Power up the middle. Over the course of this first quarter here, Greg, we'll talk through some of the numbers and the expectations. We don't want to miss some of these early plays. The Knights. Actually, that was a senior, Matt Valentine. That's nice to see him getting the starting role. Today is senior day for the Knights. We'll talk more about some of these seniors that have been here at Southern Virginia for 4 years. Had a chance to talk with big coach Ed Mulitalo, head coach for the Knights, about these seniors. These are his guys. He's been here for 4 years, and so these seniors that are graduating, many of them are men that he brought in. Another handoff to Valentine as he goes off tackle to the right. Nice stiff arm. Great job from Valentine.
Matthew Valentine on the carry.
Defense. Go ahead, Greg.
Yeah, this is a big game for the Knights. This is, like you said, Scotty, the senior night for these seniors that have been a part of this program with Coach Mulitalo with his first start here. This is the last home game here at Knight Stadium for Southern Virginia. And so I know that these Knights are itching to, end this home season with a W.
Yeah, we'll talk more about how the seniors progressed as Jalen Troy goes in motion to the left side. Double receivers to the left. Pinkston looking off to the left. Just a bit to the off the fingertips of his intended receiver. Did a great job on the cut there. It was Chase Pope coming across the middle with a little post route there. Jalen Troy comes off as the Knights will go with four wide receivers. They'll have Schenck and Wester in the slots. Skylar Johnson, the Knights' leading receiver, off to the right, and Chase Pope off to the left. Knights will go in motion. Single high safety. Opportunity for Pope on the left side. He gets almost to the marker, just past the marker, and I believe that will call that a first down. Yeah. The head referee on here on the right side calls for the moving of the chains. Great job by Pinkston finding Pope on that left side.
Scotty, this is going to be a big game for the defensive side for both teams. And I know it's something that we'll get into about the stats and the leaders in the conference. But the defense is going to, I think, determine the outcome of this game is what defense can stand up and shut the other offense down.
Finding Jacob Wood, the Knights' leading rusher. It's the first time I think we've seen him on his first carry get negative yards in a home game. Jacob Wood comes in with 436 yards total rushing. He's number one rusher for the Knights. Also one of the leading rushers in the conference. Wood comes in as the fourth leading rusher in the conference with 58.6 yards per game.
Yeah, number 34 for the Cougars, Connor Showalter, the linebacker, was able to get in and disrupt that running play.
He's their number one player on the defensive end. He leads them by far. Another quick turn and go for the Knights. That was Matthew Johansson who came in, Greg, at the beginning of the season in fall camp as the Knights' number one target. And then he got injured and missed about four games in the beginning of the season. It's nice to see him connecting with Pinkston, maybe trying to get some of that rhythm back.
Yeah, I think it is coming back. It was a little shaky, I think, in his earlier games when he did come back, but I think he's, you know, in stride now as the season is, you know, coming to these last two games.
Troy goes in motion. Double receiver set to the right side. Cade Nelson's in, picks up the blitz. Pinkston finds the slot receiver, Shank, on the right-hand side. Picks up maybe 3 yards on that.
Pinkston's pass is complete to number six.
Great job from Cade Nelson picking up the blitzing linebacker on that right-hand side.
Ball is spotted on the 32-yard line. Picks up six.
Yeah, if the Knights offense can control the line of scrimmage, they're able to control this pressure that Averett, the Cougars, are trying to bring and be able to give Pinkston this time to find his receivers. The receivers, you know, are open basically every play.
Troy on the right side picks up maybe two.
Pass is complete to number 82, Jalen Troy.
So, Greg, when we look at the game overall, there seems to be a couple things that stand out in terms of who's going to be able to win this game. When we talked about, what do you think the keys for this game are?
Well, on the Knights' offensive side, it is, you know, controlling a few of the Averett's key leaders. Tristan Quick comes in with 5.5 sacks, and so he's going to be bringing a lot of pressure in the backfield with the running backs or with Pinkston, and so if they can control that monster, they have an opportunity.
It was a big third down play here. The Knights get maybe one or two on that, so it'll be a fourth and four. This is in the range of the Knights kicking team, but it looks like Coach Mulitalo is choosing to go for this on fourth and two. Your last home game, why not? Sorry, keep going, Greg, on the keys.
Yeah, and something that they've been working on throughout this whole year is just controlling the game by staying on the field. Having these sustained long drives has been one of the keys that has, you know, helped them win a game or be able to stay in the game and give their team a chance to win.
Pinkston with the RPO has Skyler up over the top. Flag comes in as number 13 for the Cougars. Jamal Ash got there just a little bit early. That was a close one. I'm not sure that flag needed to come out.
Yeah, obviously if you're on the Knight side, good call. If you're on the Cougar side, terrible call.
Defensive pass interference, number 13.
It's just, you know, as unlucky it is, it's part of the game with, you know, these refs making calls, and they're not perfect, and so the key is to, you know, flush it down the toilet, bounce back, get into the next play, make something happen, whether you're on the Knight side or the Cougar side.
I think I'm going to say he just got there early and grabbed that arm and pulled it down with his left hand. Pinkston staying in shotgun. Two wide receivers set, two tight ends. Quick out for Skyler Johnson. He gets to the 2 yard line, 3 yard line, just short of the touchdown. So the Knights now will be first and goal from the three. These quick outs and quick in routes, post routes, everything's been quick hitters for Pinkston. I love the way Coach DuPay here is getting him in rhythm. And he's spreading the ball around. This is the fourth receiver that's caught a ball for the Knights.
Yeah, Pinkston's doing a great job hitting his target.
Freshman, Alex Langtree, in a running back. He gets the ball, looks off tackle, gets maybe a yard.
Alex Langtree, the ball carrier.
I mean, now will be second in goal from the two.
And right there, we mentioned him earlier, Tristan Quick, number 24 for the Cougars, coming in and making sure that Langtree did not get very far.
Second and goal.
Yeah, Quick is third on the team in total tackles. The Knights bring in Valentine now as he tries to go off tackle on that right-hand side, and he gets stopped for no gain. Bringing up a really important third down play.
No gain on the play.
Yeah, Quick comes in with 36 tackles on the year. as you mentioned, 5.5 sacks. Connor Showalter, number 34, Roy mentioned his name. He's first on the team with 60 total tackles. Only one for loss, a half sack, but he is just so stable there in the middle of the field. Knights now have Cade Nelson, the biggest running back. Two tight end set with an extra lineman in. Over the top to Skylar Johnson. Nothing doing. Number one, Deontay Newfill, the safety, the senior safety, 5'11 from Mabane, North Carolina, held strong right there. The Knights now will bring in their kicking team. Derek Bass, the freshman kicker from Chandler, Arizona, set to try and give the Knights an early 3-0 lead. Bass gets it away, splits the upright, and it's good. So, Greg, we get a Knights offense that's able to move that ball down the field pretty much with a good mix of run and pass, having to have a fourth down play that end up in that pass interference. Had another opportunity at fourth and goal from the three, decided to kick the field goal. But good signs for the Knights to be able to move that ball. Of course, that hasn't really been the problem all year in terms of moving the ball between the 20s. It's sort of staying away from the mistakes, the penalties, the things that would stop their drive short before they could get inside the 20.
Yeah, penalties have definitely plagued this offense, as well as interceptions. What was really great about that drive for the Knights was the ability that Pinkston had and the control that he showed with his passing, making sure that his passes were able for his receiver to catch and no one else, because he is at this time leading the conference in interceptions. But on the flip side, as we get ready to look at the Cougars offense, Bryce Jackson is number two in the conference for interceptions. And so, again, it's going to come down to the defense of who can disrupt the offense and disrupt their quarterbacks has the chance and the ability to come out on top in this game.
So there's Chase Nixon. We'll call his name a few times today. He's the senior wide receiver, 6'2", 192 pounds from Gastonia, North Carolina. There's a three-headed monster that the Knights are going to face on the receiving end: Jared Mosby, Chase Nixon, and Isaiah Grice. All three almost equal in terms of number of catches, all right at that 40 catch mark for the year. And this Everett team comes in tops in the conference in total yards and yards per game in passing. Right here we see it right away. Finding number three, Isaiah Grice. He's 6'3", 175, Burlington, North Carolina native. It's just so comforting as a quarterback to have a receiving trio like that. Here's the option up the middle. Great job finding the hole. That's Sean Wallington. He's the leading rusher for the Cougars. He's had 62 attempts, averaging 5.4 yards. So solid run per rush attempt average for Wallington.
Yeah, the Knights defense, some the keys, just like you said, Scotty, is this Cougar offense is bringing a lot of downfield threats with Bryce Jackson, number one for yards, TDs, completions, you know, has those three receivers that you mentioned. If they can make them run, they have a chance.
All right, here's the run up the middle. Vi-Vi misses the tackle, second tackle miss from Breen. And finally getting pushed out of bounds.
22, Dylan Andrew. Ball is spotted on the 46-yard line.
Sean Wallington is just a strong runner. He doesn't stop. He's a big kid, just a freshman, but 5'11", 220 pounds. Jackson back to pass. Ball's on the ground. That's a fumble. I think they're going to call it down. They're going to give that ball to the Knights. Fumble. That was Isaiah Grice and his second catch of the afternoon. Putting the ball on the ground. We didn't see any targets there of Jared Mosby, who has 110 yards average per game. He averages over 100 yards receiving per game. We didn't see him targeted once. That ball goes down, and two Knights jump on it.
Yeah, it looks like Leka Apodaca came up with that fumble. Way to play to the whistle.
Yeah, it was Apodaca.
Now that's a huge, huge get for the Knights, bringing their offense back on, be able to control such a powerful Averett offense.
Apodaca comes in fourth in the conference with 9 tackles per game. The Knights' Jason Ciosi leads the conference with 11. Run up the middle, gets maybe one, it's called 2 yards, Jacob Wood.
45-yard line. Brings up second down and 7.
You should note that Colton Shumway is in as a QB for the Knights. The sophomore from Enoch, Utah, Canyon View High School product. And this is not the first time that DuPay has done this. Daniel DuPay, the offensive coordinator, and brought Shumway in for a series. Chase Wester, the slot receiver, goes in motion, goes back. Shumway keeps that ball on the option. Take the ball right to the sticks. I think they're going to give him a first down right there. He picked up 8 yards on that run. Great job. He saw that right defensive end crash down and just barely got away. So you get around that. He doesn't look like it, but he is a good rusher. He doesn't have the strength that Pinkston does, but definitely has the quick to get to the edge, as we saw right there. Good arm as well. He's a sophomore with Pinkston graduating. He's looking to come in and solidify his position as the Knights' next quarterback. Nelson met in the backfield. Again, number 34, Connor Showalter, leading tackler for the Cougars. Meeting Nelson right there in the backfield. Nelson having nowhere to go. He's not the quickest of the Knights running backs, and you don't want to let him get ahead of steam because he is a big, strong dude. But if the Knights can't get him running north-south, it'll be really good for the Cougars as Showalter steps up, stops him right away.
Yeah, just looking on the sideline for the Knights, Scotty, it looked like Davis Pinkston was talking with the head trainer for the football team, Paul Tobias. I don't know if he's feeling a little tired or something, and maybe that's why he's taking this this set out. But it would be interesting to see if he comes back in during this drive or in the next drive.
Delay game called. First penalty on either team. That'll make it second and 15 for the Knights. Woodson Francois and Chase Wester off to the right, 3 receiver set. Johansson to the left. Shumway with an option. Hands the ball off. I think that might have been Langtree.
Alex Langtree
off the left side. Good job getting back to the original line of scrimmage. That'll bring up 3rd and 10.
Taken down at the 37-yard line.
Yeah, big 3rd down for the Knights. Something that they've sometimes have done well with 3rd down conversions. Other times they've struggled. And so they have done well so far of controlling the ball, moving down the field. This is a big 3rd down for the Knights and a big stop for the Averett Cougars.
Averett come in, they play this 4-2-5 defense, 5 defensive backs, 2 linebackers. Shumway rolls right. It's got Woodson coming back the ball, that ball well overthrown. Woodson had the angle and the leverage on the cornerback. That was Jamal Ash, the junior from Raleigh. Trying to find Trying to find Francois, the junior wide receiver from Pompano Beach, Florida. Fourth and nine. This is a place where Pinkston has often done the pooch kick. I'm sure that's what we have coming in here as Adrian Howard scrambles to get himself set up. I'm sure we'll see the pooch kick. As Pinkston will try and pin Averett deep. Pope getting ready to stop that ball right at the... You cannot put that ball any closer. Pope, really smart. In college, you can be inside the across the goal line and stop the ball. In professional, you cannot. He did a great job staying right, putting his heels on the end line, on the touchdown line, and stopping that ball at what we call it, the two-inch line. I'm not sure I've ever seen the ball closer to the touchdown line than that. So now you have Bryce Jackson with his team backed up. Dangerous place to pass. Just a quarterback sneak trying to get anything they can forward. Big surge from the offensive line. They get maybe a yard and a half on that QB sneak. Just something to get him off of the end line, off of the touchdown line. So second and nine. The Knights playing with five defensive backs, Apodaca and Ciosi, in at linebacker. Handoff off the right side. Great job by the Knights setting that corner, not allowing that bounce to get outside. Andrew jumped up from that corner position, second tackle for him on the day. Strong play from the Knights defensive backs so far.
And a big third down for the Knights defense. Again, kind of put them in a position to make them run, which is the Knights' strongest suit. That's their strength.
Yeah, the front seven for the Knights are by far maybe the strength of their whole team, that defensive line and the linebackers. Looking to get off tackle to the right. The Knights collapse that the line without any opportunity for Wellington to find a hole.
Tackle is made.
Gets a yard.
That looks like Kimani Vaivai and Dallin Breen coming in and swarming that tackle, not giving the Cougars any room to breathe. Great three and out for the Knights. Tough three and out for the Cougars.
Wellington did well to make sure he got back to the line of scrimmage on both of those runs. Not getting stuck in the backfield and possibly giving up a safety. Heels on the end line. It's a nice punt. 40-yard punt taken by Chase Wester. He'll get 8 yards on the return. So the Knights with great starting position here at, call it the 32-yard line, 31-yard line.
Yeah, and this is close to the Knights' strongest position, which would probably be the strongest position for any team once you get close to the red zone. The Knights have had a really great conversion rate, in the 90 percentile of converting in the red zone. And so they're only about 10, 12 yards off of where, you know, some good things will happen for them.
So Pinkston is back in now. He's got Jacob Wood. Hands the ball off to Wood. And Wood will push for a hard 2 yards. Be second and eight.
Looks like Kerry Dickinson, number 30 for the Cougars, the safety at 5'11", 185 from Centerville, Virginia, coming in.
So the Knights will let this first quarter end with a 3-0 lead. Great job by the Knights putting a bit of a stranglehold on the passing and total offense of the Cougars. I have no doubt that we'll see a lot more coming from Bryce Jackson. Coaching staff for the Cougars will be dialing up a lot of opportunities for Jackson, but the Knights really off that punt of Pinkston, which is a dangerous weapon. You don't see those pooch kicks very much, especially in an era where there are a lot of teams with kickers that can kick a 50-yard field goal. So you don't see that pooch kick very often with the ball being, you know, at the 35 or 40-yard line.
Yeah, a great quarter for the Knights. Time of possession, almost 11 minutes for the Knights and just under 4 minutes for the Cougars.
And the Knights still on the ball. Pinkston goes back to throw. He's going to try to find Skylar Johnson. They really weren't on the same page. Skylar Johnson looked over his left shoulder, and Pinkston did a kind of a back shoulder throw.
Number 11, Skylar Johnson.
That pass was denied by number 5, Terrell England, for the Cougars, who is number 2 in the conference for interceptions.
Cooper Stokes, the freshman fullback, will come off as the Knights go into a 3-receiver set. Langtree offset to the right. Cross the middle. Oh, just a bit too much speed on that pass for Francois Woodson.
Pinkston's pass is in.
A little behind him. The offensive line did a great job of keeping that pocket.
Fourth down and 7.
For Pinkston, he stepped up. Great throw. That's one that Woodson would like to have back, I would think.
Yeah, it brings me back to my first year playing football in seventh grade. Coach Mendenhall saying, if it touches your hands, you got to catch it. So
you better catch it. Now, fourth and 7. Pinkston with another pooch kick. This one is going to do the exact same thing to the 2-yard line. As Shank picks it up, Pinkston is player of the game as the punter right now. Again, pinning the Cougars deep, but Coach Muitalo probably not too happy with that starting position and then not having anything come of it. So now Jackson will look to get his team out of the end zone. See if they can have one time where he's not taking the snap in the end zone. Big push there from number 28, Sean Watlington, 220-pounder.
Tackle is made by number 52, Dallin Breen.
That's a great first down run for the Cougars, giving their offense a little room to breathe, a little room to work with.
Gain of 5 on the play. Brings up second down and 5.
So 5 yards on that run. Second and 5 now. First time in 6 snaps that Jackson's been outside his own end zone. Again, hands off to Wallington.
Tackle was made by number 8, Jason Ciosi.
Ciosi on the tackle, which is a very common theme for him. Mentioned that he leads the conference in tackles. He has 84 tackles on the year, 10.5 tackles per game.
The kid is only a sophomore.
And he's only a sophomore. His first down. Wallington bouncing it outside, cuts it up. Great run from Wallington. The best run we've seen from him so far.
Tackle is made by number 5.
7 yards on the run. Taloa on the tackle.
This is time out for an injury.
We have a night down.
And it looks like it might be Taloa.
So far, the Knights have 6 first downs And Averett only has three. As we see Taloa getting up there, man responsible for that tackle. Been a pretty clean game, only two penalties so far, the pass interference and the delay of game. One on the Knights, one on the Cougars. Out wide now, Chase Dixon, far right. Off to left is Jared Mosby. Shotgun. Handoff to, first time we've seen, I think that was Bailey Bowen.
Tackle is made by number 4, Lekka Apodaca.
And Bowen's listed as a wide receiver. Back there is a running back. Freshman, 165 pounder from Anderson, South Carolina. Jackson checks for the signs from the sideline. Same set, two wide receivers to the right. Tight end, single back. This time looking left is Jackson. Quick out to Dixon. Sorry, to Nixon.
Tackle is made by number 22, Dylan Andrew.
Yeah, number 22 for the Knights. Come up with that tackle, Dylan Andrew.
First down, Averett.
Looks like the Cougars offense is getting their gears turning, getting some momentum behind them, moving the ball. After two rough possessions, they're getting in the groove.
On the top, looking for the wide receiver off to the right, Chase Nixon. Great catch by Nixon. Nixon, who's a big target. The senior is 6'2", 192 pounds, goes up. Gets that ball as Alex Sewell, the defensive back, the freshman from Greenwood, California, didn't really handle that situation as Nixon goes up and pulls that down. Biggest play of the day for either team. Run pass option now, stuck in the backfield, but pushing forward. Wallington doing a great job to make something out of nothing. Gets 4 yards when he was first contact at the line of scrimmage.
Four on the play.
I'd say both offensive lines are doing a great job given the time they need to. Their quarterbacks creating holes for the running backs. But the pass games have been quick pass games from both teams. Jackson back now, the pass looks right. Just a little high, and Sewell had a chance at that. Going over the hands of his intended receiver.
Broken up by number 35, Alex Sewell.
That was number, I believe it was number 82, Nick Andrews, the intended target there. He's got 246 yards receiving on the year, 14 receptions. He's the next leading receiver after Mosby, Nixon, and Grice. But we are not seeing anything from Mosby right now. Their leading receiver, I think he might be injured, Greg. I didn't have an injury report on him, but I have not seen him targeted once. In fact, I'm not sure I've seen him on the field.
Yeah, I don't think I've seen number 6 either.
Jackson had the pocket there and looked like he rushed that pass a little bit. Not happy as he comes off the field.
Makes it fourth down and 6.
Fourth and 6, ball on the 43. Cougars will come back to pass, try and pin the Knights deep. Opportunity to push them back. They did a good job. That drive started on their own 2-yard line. Big pass to Nixon. Got them out to midfield. Then the drive stalls.
Yeah, that drive was showing a little bit of a glimpse of the power of their offense, though. This is the first time we've seen it.
Rugby-style kick. Once you go into rugby-style kick, the kicker is no longer a kicker. He's not protected. He's now a runner. So he can be run into. Heard some of the fans not happy. He got tackled as he kicked, but he is no longer protected as a kicker in that rugby style kicking.
So, Scotty, what are some of the advantages of doing that rugby style kick?
Well, what they try to do, it gives you a moment to get your players farther downfield, and you're not trying to put that thing up high. You're trying to put that on the ground, keep it out of the hands of the awaiting returner. In this case, it was Chase Wester. So you put that ball on the ground and let that momentum of the ball push forward, but you've given an extra 3 seconds to your team to get down the field and try and pin them deep. It really takes away the opportunity for the returner and get your men down far downfield to down the ball. Knights bring in another quarterback. That's number 18 for the Knights. That's Mitchell Majeski, freshman quarterback from Happy Valley, Oregon.
Yeah, it looks like number one for the Cougars, Deontay Newville, the senior safety, coming in and putting a lot of pressure. That ball barely got away and probably disrupted that pass a little bit, either definitely rushed it, if not disrupted it.
Yeah, that blitz was well-timed, especially against the freshman quarterback. Majeski in there again. It's the third quarterback for the Knights. Hand off to Cade Nelson. He powers up the middle.
Cade Nelson, the ball carrier.
Gain of six, maybe six on the
takes it
run. I'll call it five.
Brings up third down and six.
So also, so on the sideline, see Colton Shumway is on the sideline without his helmet on. Pinkston is back there. It does have his helmet. Usually just staying on the sideline without your helmet on. It means the athletic trainer is taking it from you and you're not getting in. Majeski scrambling to the right, trying to find Johansson. The ball goes through Johansson. Flag comes in. From the side judge.
Cougars definitely upset as Ty Tillman, number nine, senior safety. And then I believe number 17, Namari Borders, the junior cornerback, were in there disrupting.
It was on 17. Pass interference on 17. It'll be an automatic first down at the spot of the foul.
Maybe just a little too much contact before coming in.
Yeah, he put his hands on him. I mean, it wasn't much contact. He put his hand on his back as Johansson went to run. Knights will be called for a false start. That's a big Bryce Lampert.
We have false start.
The left tackle for the Knights. Lampert's a freshman, 6'2", 230. Now, first and 15, Majeski hands it off to Wood to his right. Wood up the middle. Gets four on the play. Almost back to the original line of scrimmage.
Wood did a good job controlling that ball. I think the handoff was a little low and outside. He was able to bring it in and be able to guard it before he made any contact. It was a split second too early or earlier. That ball probably would have been on the ground.
Majeski brings Wester in motion back to the right side. Looking up over the top. And it's intercepted off to the hands of Shank. Still running. On that left side, that was a great job from Terrell England, the senior, making a senior play. Just a little bit over the hands of Shank, who tips it. And England does a great job focusing on that ball and then returning it another 25 yards to the 28-yard line. Scratched at a 22-yard line.
Great job reeling that one in, bobbled a little bit, and I think that makes three interceptions for Terrell on the season.
So now Jackson in the backfield ready to take this snap. Wallington off to his left. Goes to his second read. In the middle, great catch. Flag goes down. Didn't matter because Isaiah Grice goes up and grabs that ball, shields off his defender. Incredible play by Grice. making up for that fumble. So one play after the interception, and Cougars go for the end zone, and Grice comes down with it. Will Cavanis now to take the extra point. He came in 20 for 24 on the year, puts that one through. And the Cougars go up 7-3. You mentioned it, Greg, the power of this offense in the passing game was evident a little earlier. A couple of those drives we saw between Grice and Nixon. There's a lot there. The Knights aren't even having to face the number one receiver, Jared Mosby. Yet still, that passing attack for the Cougars is very potent.
Yeah, and that right there kind of shows what has been the weakest part of the Knights' offense. Is we saw a penalty, a false start just after they got, a little lucky break or bad call, good call about that pass interference. Depends on how you look at it. Able to get down and then false start, bring it back a little bit, try to look downfield with a young quarterback and have that interception. The turnovers and the penalties is what has plagued this offense. And the beginning of this game, they were doing really well of controlling the game, controlling the ball. But it's a little interesting to see these young quarterbacks and Pinkston not in there today. So it'll be interesting to see if he comes back in after that.
Yeah, the Knights came in with 11 interceptions. That's the 12th interception for the Knights on the year. And as the ball goes out of bounds, not what you want on the kicking team. Flag goes down. So the Knights will have decent starting field position. And we'll see who comes out at quarterback.
Ball kicked out of bounds, number 31 on the kicking team. Ball placed on the 35.
So now on the 35-yard line. Averett comes in at 2-3 in the conference, which puts them 6th in the conference. The Knights are 8th in the conference, 1-5. Overall, the Knights are 2-6. Averett's 3-4. But the real distinction, is, as you talked about at the beginning, Greg, has been the potent passing attack. And then the Knights, which are at the bottom of the conference in passing yards given up. Pinkston is back in. Hands off to Nelson. The Knights are really committed to this running game.
Ball carrier. Taken down at the,
yeah, it's definitely something they've done in the past. They've tried to control the line of scrimmage, get yards, get field position by the running game to be able to open up some things down the field.
I had a chance to talk with Coach Mulitalo earlier in the week, and talking about this offensive line, he's like, they're just so young. They want to do gap schemes. They want to do pushing ahead running. They're just young. Pinkston now taking off, tucks the ball, and will get, call it 8 yards. It was 3rd and 9. Sorry, it was 2nd and 9. Now it's 3rd and 1.
Brings up 3rd down and 1.
Pinkston looks like he was running kind of gingerly right there.
Yeah, when he was on the sideline, it looked like his hip. He was definitely kind of limping. It looked like, yeah, definitely, as you said, he wasn't running as powerful as we know Pinkston can run.
Shumway, with his helmet off, not able to go back in. Pinkston really needs to be in the game right now. Quick out to Jalen Troy. Nicholas Mintz, the senior linebacker from Burlington, put a little hit on him. The Knights are going to punt this at 4th and 1. Surprised they went for that pass right there. The Knights have been, they haven't been stopped in the backfield, but maybe once on their runs. Thought you give that ball to Cade Nelson, you'd get something up the middle.
Yeah, the Cougars definitely brought the heat, though, on that play. just a little unlucky with not being able to connect with Troy.
So Jalen Troy comes from Danville, Virginia. It's a big game for him. That's where the Cougars are at. That's where their home is in Danville, Virginia. Well, that ball took a heck of a bounce. Knights kick team were chasing it down, and we're not at all ready for that play. As that ball hit the ground and bounced, Darren Rice chasing that down. The Charlotte, North Carolina freshman.
Yeah, I think Darren probably could have gotten to the ball. I think he hesitated a little bit, not knowing if the Cougars were going to try to return that. So he bit a little bit, but now the Cougars offense comes out, and as we saw in their last drive, in one play, very powerful.
Yeah, they bring in three of the top six receivers. Even though Mosby is out, Nixon is fourth in the conference with 74 yards per game, and Grice, who caught that touchdown, is sixth in the conference with 65 yards per game. This ball goes out to Grice. Good job by Sewell on the tackle. Grice gets 7 yards on the play. The Knights are about to be tested, Greg. They're really going to be pushed as the rhythm and the play calling for the Cougars starting to really favor this passing game. Jackson now does hand off up the middle. Bailey Bowen gets, call it, 3 yards, not quite to the 30, which is where he needed to get to for the first down. So it'll be third and one.
Blake Huber with the tackle.
Blake Huber on the tackle.
Third down and one.
This offensive line, the big solid, led by Brock Lucas, the senior, big 6'6", 275 from Bedford, Virginia. Attended Liberty High School.
Down close to Smith Mountain Lake, which is a beautiful place to visit.
That is a beautiful place to visit. Handoff. Nice cutback. Finding that lane. That was Bryce Phillips, the freshman running back. 5'6", 190. He's a bowling ball from Newport News and did a great job. Finding that quick cutback. First down call for Jackson as he brings Nixon in motion. Option play goes back to Phipps. Phipps did a great job getting 9 yards on that carry.
Yeah, the Cougars are being really lethal right now. They are controlling the run game. They're getting yards on this Knights defense, whose their strongest suit is, you know, controlling the run game. So this is going to open up a lot of options for the Cougars offense.
Yeah, these RPOs are going to start to turn into pass rather than runs. It was great job coming back from the backside from Logan Mullen, the freshman defensive end from Bountiful.
Is made by number 51, Logan Mullen. Make some noise, Knight fans. It's third and two.
Mullen, 6'3", 250, did a great job running down that play from the backside. Jason Ciosi, right up the hole, trying to get that first down. Was Bryce Phipps, and you can see why. I mean that's a big, I mean, he's really strong, 5'6", 190, but Jason Ciosi and he had an epic collision about a yard behind the line of scrimmage, and Ciosi won that battle.
Yeah, any young football players watching that is what you got to pause, rewind, slow down, slow motion, watch how Ciosi filled that hole and blew up in the backfield.
So this will force a punt from the Cougars. As Wester's back to return this, calls for a fair catch. Goes over his head, dies at the 5-yard line. Great kick. Fantastic job from number 26, Mason Smith, the sophomore kicker.
5-yard line.
You can see Chase Wester trying to throw off the Cougars punt team with his fake fair catch and then walking off, you could tell that that was not the right decision, owning that one.
So now, with his helmet back on, is Shumway. Shumway back in. It's a merry-go-round of quarterbacks for the Knights. Dupay trying to have a figure, trying to figure out how to manage through. Each one of these quarterbacks has different strengths. Jacob Wood gets to the outside. One stiff arm, then a second. His best run of the afternoon results in a first down for the Knights.
First down.
Great job running off tackle there as Andrew Sutherby, the big freshman left tackle, set that edge and was able to give him the 6'7", 350. Can't miss Andrew out there. Can't miss him on campus. Can't miss him on the field. Again, Wood in the backfield with Colton Shumway. Option handoff finds Jalen Troy, the Danville native. Takes a big hit, pops up.
His pass is complete to number 82, Jalon Troy. Ball is spotted on the 21-yard line.
So a four-yard gain.
Second down and six.
The Knights offense with just 3 minutes left to go in this first half. Got to be able to get down the field. Be able to, if not get any points, at least put the Cougars in a harder position to do anything else before this half ends.
The out route found by Shumway finds Crew Huxford.
Shumway's
that was a beautiful pass.
13, Crew Huxford.
Huxford, involved with the return game on the kickoffs, has worked his way into the playing lineup on the receiving end for the Knights as well.
Yeah, just like you said, Scotty, great placement on that pass. Only Huxford could have caught that ball.
Quick flip to Chase Wester. Great job scouting that out and sniffing out that play as Wester had to avoid the first Cougar player and then swing to the outside, but there was only room for a single yard right there. The Knights bring Troy back in. Shank in the slot on the right. Leading receiver Skylar Johnson off to the right. Chase Pope off to the left. Going deep, looking for his receiver, Shank. Is Cole Shumway. Shank goes up and finds it.
Shumway's pass is complete to number six. Jay
biggest play of the
Shank.
Afternoon for the Knights.
Ball is spotted on the Averett 34-yard line. Another Knights first down.
Shumway can put the ball. He's got a nice touch on it. His passes have been really close. Even the interception was just barely off the fingertips of Shank. Now he looks to the left. Finds Johansson. Johansson, he is still up. Fighting all the way. Gets maybe 8 yards after the catch. Flag comes in at the end.
Matthew Johansson was fighting, I think, nine of the Cougars' defense right there. There's only two that were not near the play.
I guess if you go to a dark alley, you want Johansson, if he's willing to fight that many guys at one time.
You might have to put a ball in his hands and then he'll fight.
put a ball in his hand and then. So, conversation now from the side judge. See what this call is.
We have a legal blocker back. Number nine on the offense. Being 10 yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Remains first down.
That was not a very smart decision by Chase Wester coming in. The play was basically dead, and he just comes up and blows up a Cougar, kind of apparently for no reason.
Yeah, Jaquan Webb was, sorry, no, David Payne. It was David Payne, the safety, the senior safety. As Johansson was going down, Wester came up behind and you said blew him up. And just not a smart play. You like the aggression. You need that. Wester is really developing into a strong player for the Knights. Still results in a first down. It'll be first and five. After the 10-yard penalty, they'll give him the first down. They go back 10 yards. The result of the play is a first and five off of that play from Johansson. So the Knights now 55 seconds left. They have two timeouts left.
Thank you.
Colton Shumway hands the ball off. Fake pass goes back to Shumway. He's got a little room as he gets to the 15-yard line. A little razzle-dazzle. That play looked like it was going to blow up on this left side. Like the Cougars had it scouted out, and then Shumway said, no, this is Applebee's date night. Let me get fancy. Turns into a handoff reverse to a quarterback pass.
My heart was definitely racing. I was a little confused of what was happening. And then, like you said, Scotty, a little razzle-dazzle.
Great pass. I think it was Huxford on the pass. His first completed pass of the year.
It's a great pass.
Knights have Holmes and Troy on the left side. Ball is juggled by Wood. That kind of thing will happen sometimes with a new quarterback in. Shumway kind of pounds his chest. And my fault. Wood did a good job corralling that ball as the Knights call timeout. It'll be second and 10, 40 seconds left.
That's the second time Wood has done a great job, you know, handling a mishandled handoff.
Hey, what did he do?
That was already a tongue twister, so I'm not going to try again.
No, that's why they pay us the big bucks so we can handle tongue twisters like that. Although you brought that one on yourself, Greg.
Ah, you're right, Scotty. Won't do it again.
All right, so now DuPay talking to his coaching staff on the sideline. Hughie and Hoffman down there making the play calls for DuPay, who is up in the box. Coach Mulitalo puts a lot of trust and faith in his offensive staff, letting DuPay put together the game plan, and well, they put it together. Mulitalo is very much a man who believes in trust and delegation. 9 years with the Ravens, spent time with the Lions as well. Shumway looking to go over the top to Johnson. Perfect pass! Finds the ball to Skyler Johnson. Celebration by the Knights. Great out route to the sideline by Skyler Johnson as he was going up against Deontay Newfill as well as their cornerback, Kendall McClary. Isaiah Sharpner, sorry, the junior, Isaiah Sharpner. The Knights now looking to go for two, but this is a kind of common thing for them. Brings it back in, says, nope, we'll go for one. Vassell, see if he can't split the uprights with this one. Been very consistent. Tough handle. Bass didn't even get a chance as the ball hit the ground. That was Kyle Barilla, who, freshman wide receiver, handled the holding duties for, I think, most of the year. That ball hit the ground. Hughie comes over, lets him know what he wants him to do. He's talking to the snapper. He's talking to those guys. Get together. Let's fix it up.
Great drive for the Knights, though, Scotty.
Yeah,
being pinned back from, they started at the five, if I remember correctly, from that great punt for the Cougars. and then a 95-yard drive.
With 35 seconds left, they'll put the ball back in the hands of the Cougars. Knights' best drive of the afternoon, giving them the two-point lead. Warming up on the Cougars' sideline is their kicker, Will Cavanis, the 6'1 junior, hoping to get a chance to try a field goal.
Yeah, we know with Bryce Jackson and the Cougar offense, they do have the tools and the ability to move the ball very efficiently. And so wouldn't be surprised to see them possibly get down into field goal range.
Yeah, Nixon will take this kickoff. He has a lane. He's out to the 30. Bass looks to make the tackle. Bass can't make the tackle, but slows him up enough for Colby Hyder, the sophomore from Roosevelt, Utah, to come over and clean it up. All the way to the 35-yard line. Excellent return from Nixon.
Gotta throw the ball.
So if they can get another 30 yards, they'll put their kicker, Cavanis, in a position to be able to take a field goal. He has range from about the 45 to 50 yard. So if they can get that ball to the 35 of the Knights, they'll have a chance. That's only 30 yards, 27 seconds, three timeouts. Jackson looking to his right, scrambling as he's being chased down, finds his tight end. That's Bigtavian Goffigan, the sophomore from Virginia Beach.
Complete to the 49-yard line. First down, Averett.
Four wide receiver set. Now Nixon off to the right along with the leading receiver, Isaiah Grice. Jackson making sure everybody's set right. He's going to look back right. Comes to Nixon. Great job by Nixon to get the first down and get out of bounds. 16 seconds left.
This is complete. Forced out of bounds by number 22, Dylan Andrew.
Dylan Andrew, the starting defensive back for the Knights, was there for the stop. Good job moving this ball. They can get a field goal. They can get themselves back in the lead. Jackson scrambles to his right. Wide open over the middle. But bobbled. Nixon had that ball and bobbled it on the catch. If he hadn't bobbled it, he was going to come down with that ball. Now it's 9 seconds. Decision to make. You can easily get a play with the three timeouts. Get a pass off. Probably one play and then kick the ball, or if you want to go for a touchdown. There's probably only two plays left in this half, though. Triple receivers to the left as Grice comes in motion. Knights in a zone defense. Having a scramble is Jackson. Looking to go up over the top. And the ball is knocked out. They're going to call that a touchdown. Ball just over the head of Dylan Andrew. He never turned around. All he had to do was put his hand up. He didn't turn around to see that ball coming in. Impressive drive. 35 seconds. So in 33 seconds, Jackson takes his team the length of the field to get a touchdown as he scrambled off to the right.
I guess they call it a fumble and then
a recovery.
Recovery to get a touchdown. That's what it looks like.
Fantastic play. Seconds to move the ball the length of the field, starting at the 35-yard line off that really solid return from Nixon.
Yeah, I don't know if the Knights defense was just a little surprised of how quickly they were moving the ball. Like you said, Scotty, they were in a zone defense, and the Cougars were just able to find a lot of little soft spots to be able to hit their target.
Nixon is doing a great job. So again, without their leading receiver, Jared Mosby, and Nixon and Grice have really taken over. Nixon goes up over the top of the Knights defender to grab that ball and pull it in. So 2 seconds left. Probably take a knee here with a young quarterback at the helm. Oh, great game so far. Both teams moving the ball. The Knights showing the youth that they have in the secondary and really allowing a lot of movement up and down the field. But also the management from Shumway and finding opportunities for the Knights to move the ball both in the run and the pass game as Pinkston does take a knee. And the Knights will go in down 5. 14-9. Looking over the stats, Greg, Knights have 12 first downs, able to move this ball, especially that last drive, as you mentioned, 95 yards, bodes well for the Knights. Knights only one of six on first down for 17%.
Cross country championships today.
Yeah, for that third down conversion.
Yeah,
one of six. Yep.
The Knights 201 total yards versus 196 for Averett. Rushing yards 59 for the Knights and 61 for the Cougars. So this is really a neck-and-neck game. The Cougars are up 5, but the Knights have moved the ball just as well as the Cougars have, and the stats show it. So this is really anybody's game. The Knights are led in the rushing category with 20 yards from Jacob Wood. Matt Johansson has 35 yards on 2 receptions. Schenk, 33 yards on 2 receptions. Skylar Johnson, who caught that TD, also has 2 receptions. For the Cougars, Sean Watlington has 37 yards, averaging 4.6 per rush. A little under his season average, but doing a great job. Bryce Phipps, the strong 5'6", 190-pound freshman, also with 4 rushes. And then 3 receivers have caught 9 balls. For Jackson, Nixon with 3 for 77 yards. Isaiah Grice with 5 receptions for 48 yards. Nixon has just really been tearing it up. He had the great return. So going into the second half, you know, for the Cougars, they'll want to keep that passing game going and see if they can't stifle the young quarterback, Colton Shumway, and get in the backfield and get a little more pressure on him. Conversely, you know, can the Knights stop Nixon and Grice and Jackson in that passing game?
Yeah, it is. It seemed like the Cougars were very powerful when they were trying to move the ball quickly. They had a really short field on their first touchdown, but right there they were just trying to move the ball quickly, which I think through the Knights defense just kind of just a little whirlwind, not for sure exactly how to contain or control. Like you said, Scotty, all their threats. So it will be a fun and exciting second half. We're, again, grateful for you guys joining us, you know, live, wherever you're at. Thank you for tuning in. And we will get back to you, you know, a few minutes before the second half.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give a big round of applause and welcome to the field our very own Marching Knights as they perform Hip to Be Square. The Marching Knights conclude their halftime performance with Tom Wallace's arrangement of Come Out and Play.
So let's come in and talk about 5 minutes left. Talk about this. And talk about the women's soccer.
please show your spirit by joining the band and cheer squad in the SVU fight song. As our marching band concludes their inaugural season, they want to give our SVU community a big thank you for all your support and encouragement. Go Knights!
Thank you.
legion of fans been tailgating since about 9 o'clock this morning. The Cougars lead the Knights 14-9. Looking over the stats, we mentioned some of these earlier. The 201 yards for the Knights versus 196 for the Cougars really showed the quality of this first half between these two teams. They did a great job together. The Knights doing a good job in combination. But it's really been the play of two players that have set this thing off. I think, Greg, the play of the receiving core, specifically Isaiah Grice and Chase Nixon, that has been the standout performers of this game. But Cole Shumway coming in substitution for Pinkston has done a great job as well.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see. Be interesting to see on the second half how Shumway and Pinkston are used on the offensive side. The like you said, Scotty, the power of the Cougars is the bane of the Knights defense, which is passing down the field. We talked a little bit before we went to break about the difference with these stats in the first half between Averett and Southern Virginia. And with just 5 yards less for the Averett offense, they've done that in 12 less plays. And so they are very efficient going down the field and very lethal. And so the Knights defense, I'm sure they were talking in the locker room just barely about how to control and try to contain Bryce Jackson, put him under pressure, or be able to, you know, handle these huge threats that the Cougars have. So I'm excited for the second half. And I know you all that are watching are as well.
A couple quick notes talking about the Knights athletic department. Today, the cross-country team of the Knights, headed by Coach Kyle Chandler and his wife Jamie Chandler as an assistant, the men and the women just won the USA South Championship. So congratulations to the cross-country team coming in their first year in the USA South, winning the conference championship. That's great for them. In addition, the Knights this evening will host their first women's soccer playoff game ever. In fact, it's the first time they've ever been in a conference playoff. And the Knights yesterday had four players receive conference honors, headed by McKenna Winterton, who received all-conference first team as a forward, though she played half the season as a sweeper fullback for Coach Dahl. Did a fantastic job in recruiting and coaching this team. Also awarded honors were freshman Anna Roberts and Ella Thomas, who were also first team along with Winterton in the East Division section, and Micaiah Lindgren, who leads the team in total points, goals, and assists, was second team all East Division. So the Knights with four players with postseason accolades, and then tonight at 5, hopefully you'll join us for that conference playoff game. You'll be against the third place team from the West, Maryville, coming in from Tennessee. A great opportunity for the Knights to host this game, and if you're a Knights fan, hopefully get a win.
Yeah, just a reminder, though, Knight fan out there, make sure you are following Knight Football on Instagram. That's Knight_FTBL to get awesome replay action of what this game has to offer.
Bass putting that ball in the air, finds Nixon. Nixon finding another hole, almost breaks. It gets to the 34-yard line. He is dangerous back there, but the blocking has been fantastic for the Cougars in kick return. So starting with the ball are the Cougars. The Knights will come out in their 4-2-5. Dallin Breen, Kimani Vaivai anchoring that defensive line. Of course, Leka Apodaca and Jason Ciosi, the two linebackers. Finding immediately as that quick slant route for the Cougars. That was number 83 for the Cougars. That's Tavion Goffigan. Goffigan, the only other receiver to catch a ball besides Nixon and Grice. That's his second catch on the afternoon. Jackson with the handoff up the middle. Sean Watlington, the freshman on the run.
52, Dallin Green.
Watlington's going to be a strong runner for this team. Just a freshman, 220 pounds, local product. Went to George Washington High School. Living in Danville, didn't go to the same high school as Jalen Troy, the Knights tight end. Jackson looks to his left, coming over the middle with a big hit on Goffigan. Was Lekka Apodaca, knocks the ball loose, and Goffigan. Goffigan holding his head. Looks like he has hit his head pretty hard on the ground on that hit. That'll bring up a third and six as the athletic training staff for the Cougars come out to attend to Goffigan.
That's one thing you have to be careful with, is throwing it in the middle with beasts like Lekka and Jason. That's like a spitting image of one of my favorite shots of Lekka from the 2018 season, I think. He did the exact same thing to a player from William Patterson. But looks like he's getting up, which is a good sign.
Yeah, definitely.
He's running off the field. So going to be seeing him back, I believe, shortly.
So back again is Jackson. Nice out route going down though to the ground, killing the play. Having to go down and pick that up was Marquise Woodruff, the freshman wide receiver from Lynchburg. That will result in a first down. Good job securing that pass, making sure he just got the first down. Wanted to get up and run from that, did Woodruff, but first things first, he got the, corralled the ball on that low pass from Jackson, doing a good job moving the sticks. Five wide receiver set for Jackson. Little out route from Nixon. Nimble of foot is the big wide receiver.
Tackle is made by number 35, Alex Sewell.
It's kind of interesting to see how the Knights defense are trying to handle the Cougars' potent offense. Seems that they are kind of only bringing three, maybe four, and they're putting a lot of weight on those three or four to put pressure on Jackson. And they're trying to keep a lot of people, you know, downfield, but the Cougars' offense are still able to find a lot of spots.
The RPO pulls it out. Does Jackson finds his receiver, Nick Andrews, coming across the middle. The diminutive receiver, 5'7", 150 pounds from Roanoke, did a good job securing that ball. Jackson back with Bailey Bowen, the freshman, in the backfield with him. Triple wide receivers off to the left. The RPO again. Bowen dancing in and out, and he will find close to the end zone down at the 1 yard line. Great run from Bowen, dancing in and out. Good patience. Taloa eventually forcing him out.
First and goal,
Averett. Yeah, back to that big hit. You know, Apodaca is 230 pounds, 6'1 senior. Even though he's a family human development major, he can bring and lay the lumber. Hopefully we'll be able to see.
Kick
Gaffigan back in. Still being attended to over on the sideline. Apodaca is one of the nine seniors. Big run up there, left tackle. It's number 38. That's Bryce Phipps, second leading rusher on the afternoon for the Cougars. Takes that into the end zone. Very impressive drive as Toloa is slow to get up. Pretty incredible drive for this team's 65-yard drive starting at the 35-yard line. Moved it down the field mostly with the passing game, finding a run now and then.
Looks like Jacob Toloa a little shaken up after that play, but able to walk off the field.
Holding that left arm gingerly. So now to try the extra point is Will Cavanis. Holding for him is Ryle Curl, backup quarterback. And it's good. So 21-9, 12-point lead. And this will be a challenge. See if the Knights can come out and respond. What does Danny Dupay and his offense have in store? So talking with Big Ed yesterday, Knights head coach, he put an offer out there for all of the Knights students. Because the playoff game this afternoon is a conference game, they have to charge. It's like $5 per person, $3 per student, something like that. And Coach Ed said, I'm going to pay for every student that comes. So if you're a student out there getting into this playoff game three, because Coach Muitalo, and I asked him why. I was like, well, why are you going to do that? He goes, we got to show solidarity in the athletic department, support for each other. And he really means it. He's such a family guy, family oriented. So, you know, Winterton is the first all-conference player for the women that the Knights have ever had. Three others, postseason honors. Just a great opportunity for the Knights Athletic Department to celebrate excellence. The Knights women volleyball team are leading the conference right now. So some really great opportunities for the Knights Athletic Department. That ball fumbled by Huxford. He's able to get it back and get out to the 20. So no harm, no foul.
Crew Huxford on the return.
Couple other guys, Greg, that were honored this afternoon. Matt Valentine, Angel Medina, Skylar Johnson, Dallin Breen, Justin Mitchell, Davis Pinkston, Lepa Akadak, as I mentioned, Dylan Almond, all honored for their senior play. And we really are grateful for them. These are men that came in, many of them with Coach Muitalo when Coach Muitalo became the head coach. And these are all, you know, contributors. You know, many of these are strong contributors on this team. So in is Pinkston instead of Shumway at quarterback. Hands the ball off to Cade Nelson. Dive play up the middle. Gets
Cade Nelson the ball.
Maybe four.
No gain on the play.
Oh, sorry. No gain. I missaw that.
Just looking at some of the stats, it seems like the Cougar offense is just like get in, get down to business, and get off the field, whereas the Knights, with over four more minutes, almost 5 minutes of possession more, are down 12 points. And so the Knights offense has to come together, be a little bit more surgical, be able to control the ball and make something happen. Because as we can tell, the Knights defense is struggling a little bit of learning how to or figuring out how to contain the Cougars' strong offensive power.
Yeah, the Cougars scoring on their last touchdowns on their last two drives.
And very quickly as well.
The Knights bring in three wide receivers. Skylar Johnson will be off to the right. Wester in the slot to the left with Pope wide. And Jacob Wood in. Man-to-man defense. Rush three. Finds the outlet to Wood. Wood will get 12, 13 yards on the play. Pick up the first down as Pinkston steps up in that three-man rush. Wood came out of the backfield.
Ball is spotted on the 33-yard line.
Initially was a four-man route that was covered well by the eight defenders, but Wood slipping out of the backfield and Pinkston finding him. That was great. Handoff up the middle to Wood. Wood fighting for extra yardage. Falls forward.
Jacob Wood, the
picking up
here.
7 yards on the play.
Takes it out. Call to six. 39-yard line.
First and four from the 39. Second and four, sorry, from the 39. Great blocking there. Cooper Stokes on that right hand side, the freshman fullback from McCall, Idaho. Pinkston again with that similar wide receiver set. Again off the right side.
Jacob Wood with the carry.
Able to get enough to get to another first down. Just good to see the Knights offense moving down the field, staying on the field, having a sustained drive.
Running behind David Tongaloa. Over there on that right side. Jalen Troy also involved in the blocking. Knights now, two wide receiver, tight end and an H-back. Flag down, looks like we might have had a false start. Yeah, false start on the Knights. So it'll be first and 15.
Before the snap, we have false start, number 64 of the offense. 5-yard penalty.
Second false start today on the Knights. Important drive for the Knights to answer that touchdown. If you include the one that took 33 seconds at the end of the second quarter. A quick 14 points for the Cougars. Knights need to answer. Pinkston throwing the out to Johnson. He's met right away. Picks up two, maybe three.
Pinkston's pass is complete to number 11, Skylar Johnson.
Yeah, number 13 for the Cougars, Jamal Ash, a junior, breaking on that ball very well.
Yeah, great job securing Johnson as he came in.
On the play. Brings up second and
you mentioned earlier about the young O-line that the Knights have, and just looking over the roster for the Cougars, it's the complete opposite, where it's all juniors and seniors, and you can see that the power of that experience and that, you know, those live reps is really, the Cougars are doing a better job of putting pressure on the Knights front five.
Cross the middle, ball off the fingertips of Matt Johansson. It was a solid pass from
number two, Matthew Johansson.
Pinkston. Just barely not able to corral that ball. Knights bring in three new receivers. Fake handoff, flushed out of the pocket, and he will get sacked in the backfield. That was number 8, the defensive end, Isaac Mosby.
Sacked on the play.
the 5'10", 220-pounder from Chesterfield gets to Pinkston as he was trying to scramble out. They brought the blitz. Knight's not able to pick it up. That pressure came right up the middle. So the Knights now forced to punt at 4th and 18. As Derek Bass, who does the more traditional punting for the Knights, as well as the kicking, goes back to punt. Big high spiral, fair catch called for by Grice. That'll put them at the 32-yard line. Back on the ball.
Fair caught on the Averett 27-yard line.
Oh, Russ, sorry, the 27. So now Jackson brings his offense onto the field. And the Knights gonna have to show some toughness and some metal right here. They're gonna have to get to Jackson, who currently has 181 yards passing. He's 13 for 17. Make that 14 for 18 as he finds Grice off to the outside, forced out of bounds by the defensive backs of the Knights, but coming out that quick out pass. Fantastic play call. Now in a bit of a hurry up, like you mentioned, Greg, they did better in the first half in the hurry up. Grice in the slot off to the left. Gaffigan back in, that's good to see. And off the running back, able to get off tackle, falling behind big number 59, the pulling offensive lineman, Jameer Wright, leading the way, the senior lineman, 6'2", 340 from Newport News, doing a great job.
Ball is spotted on the 42-yard line. Brings up second down and six.
Good patience from the run game as Watlington just went right behind him. Just cool as could be, letting the road graders clear the way. 4 yards, second and six. Again, Wallington off left tackle. This time, Kamani Vaivai there to grab him and put him down after a gain of call it one.
Tackle
so third and five, third and four for the Cougars. Big third down.
The
Cougars are 3 of 6 on third down.
Third down and four.
Knights need to get off the field. Give their offense another opportunity. Jackson has a four wide receiver set. As Grice goes in motion, the Knights playing a zone. Just over the top of the outstretched hands of Apodaca is Grice, with a great pass from Jackson as he put those just that ball perfectly over the linebacker who didn't get enough depth to stop that play.
I think what's making the difference right now, Scotty, it comes down to two things. How are the defensive backs handling their responsibilities, and then how are the defensive line putting pressure on the quarterback? Jackson is having the ability to be able to see down the field, unlike where Davis is getting pressured. The cornerbacks for the Cougars are doing a great job of handling their responsibilities, their matches, 1v1 or their zone. And the Knights defense is, you know, letting just have some soft spots, not big spots, but these little spots for Jackson to find and put the ball for his receiver to get.
Right, and these run plays to Wallington, just to keep the Knights honest. That was a 4-yard run. Wallington's very patient runner, big back, patient. When he finds the hole, he hits it hard. 1-on-1 to Sewell on the left side, but over the outstretched arms of Nixon. Great opportunity for Jackson. He identifies the 1-on-1 opportunity. Sewell versus Nixon on that left side was a great game plan for Jackson. You see that 1-on-1 on that side. Knights are in a single high safety set. They're going to have one-on-one on the left-hand side again. He could go right back there. The Cougars have big Wesley Parker, the 245-pounder, on the right side. As he comes across the middle. Interception, miscommunication from Jackson and his wide receiver.
The ball is
and then the interception right in the arms of Blake Hubert, the freshman defensive back from Woodlands, Texas. Went to Woodlands High School. He's played in some big games in his day. Texas high school ball. That's something that the Knights needed to stem the tide as the Cougars were moving that ball down the field, unchecked, looking to go in for another score and put the Knights down by three scores. Now they're still just 12 down.
Yeah, huge play for the Knights defense. We talked about it, how Davis unfortunately leads the conference in interceptions, but right behind him, and number two, is Jackson. And so maybe, just like you said, miscommunication, definitely unlucky for the Cougars offense.
Oh, as that pass is snagged out of the air by the defensive leader for the Cougars, and then the pick six as Connor Showalter reaches up, the graduate student at Averett University, grabs that ball out of the air, like 4 yards from the hands of Colton Shumway, and then returns the ball for a touchdown. What an incredible play. The turnaround.
I think that was all designed for the Cougars. They wanted to maybe possibly give the Knights a little hope, a little glimmer of light. But they come on the defensive side and say, we're just messing around with you.
Well, that is an incredible play.
Big play for the Cougars.
As the extra point is good and the Cougars go up 28-9. The Knights now down by 21 points. Down by 19 points. So that's the second interception of the afternoon for Shumway. Be interesting to see how the Cougars respond. You know, their defense on that side is going to be really hyped up, flying all over the field. And then how is Dupe and his offensive coordinator, as offensive coordinator and his staff, Coach Muitalo, what are they going to do? Are they going to put Shumway back out there? Are they going to put Pinkston? Pinkston seems to be a little hobbled, a little slowed down. I'm not sure what's going on with that.
Yeah, I think you got to go with some, if Pinkston is able to, you got to go with that senior leadership. He needs to be able to control, kind of calm everybody down, just let them, you know, there still is time. There's 19 minutes left in this game, and they know that if they can rally together, that this Knight offense can move the ball and make great things happen. But if Pinkston is unable, it's just kind of a wild card having these younger quarterbacks going in.
Huxford taking the ball to the 6-yard line. Looks like we'll get a block in the back. Flag down. I think they're going to grab Hyder.
Illegal block in the back. Number 16, the return team. 10-yard penalty. First down, Southern Virginia.
So the Knights will start on their 10-yard line. Last time they were in this position, they were able to march down the length of the field and score a touchdown. Just got to get a little bit better protection for Pinkston, but the quick routes were really the solve and the balm for the offensive woes in terms of the pressure that Pinkston was seeing early in the game. He was hitting those quick out routes, quick button hooks, cutback on the counter play from Wood. He'll get the ball out to the 16-yard line. Nice 6-yard run from Wood. they started left, but following the pulling guard for the Knights was Wood.
Oh,
sorry, that was Valentine.
Gain of six.
The senior Valentine.
Second and four.
Valentine Luna is earning a degree in psychology, and he's headed to graduate school to become a marriage therapist. Still on his feet. Rumbling down the field. Great job from Valentine again. Strong run. Coming into this game, he'd had 28 rush attempts for 117 yards in his playing career. Doing a great job.
It's a first down, Knights.
Pinkston looking to lead this offense down. They need a touchdown. They got to get back in this game. Hand off again to Valentine off that right side. This time not quite successful. Only pick up a couple yards. Pinkston is graduating. He's pre-med. He's headed to Dell Medical School in Austin, Texas. Family lives in Texas now. He wants to go into physical medicine, rehabilitation. He's completed 294 passes in his career, Greg. 33 touchdowns. And leaves the program as the all-time leading passer with 3,723 yards in his career.
Valentine
again.
Takes it out to the
getting 4 or 5 yards. Valentine, the workhorse on this drive.
Yeah, it's great to see Valentine out there on senior. Coming in as a freshman, he was behind Akiva Wedge, who was the Knights' all-time leading rusher. And so I don't think he got as many reps, but I think now that he's getting older, it's kind of his body has kind of held him back from, I think, getting more reps. Just talking to him the other day in the training room, trying to rehab a foot injury.
On 3rd and 4, the Knights try to run up the middle. Looks like they'll be stopped short. Yep. No yards on that. Valentine didn't get anywhere.
Brings up
4th and 3, and the Knights will come out with their punt team. Interesting. Down by 19, you need 3 touchdowns to get back in this game. And 4th and 3 on the 42. Watch out for a fake here. Nope. Derek Bass, the high kick. Falls a little short, but gets a friendly bounce. No roll to the 17, 18, maybe the, yeah, probably the 17-yard line.
Is down on the Averett 17-yard line.
All right, well, this is a moment for the Knights defense to step up.
Please put 28 seconds on the game clock. 28 seconds.
28 seconds left in the quarter. So far, Jackson with 225 yards passing, but more impressively, he's 15 for 21 with 2 TDs and 1 interception. He hands off to the running back. That was number 11, Bailey Bowen. But chased down from the backside was Blake Hubert, getting on his horse and getting there. The man who had the interception just a few minutes ago, doing a great job coming out of that safety spot. Step down, grabbing Bowen. As the clock runs down in the third quarter, the Knights, down by 19, have an uphill road to get back in this game. Cougars will try to spend as much time as possible. They don't really need to do much, but use up 3 or 4 or 5 minutes on each possession, and it'll just be a war of attrition for the Knights to get back in this. So the Knights need to have a three and out here, get their offense back on the field, and get them a chance to start to move that ball. It was Knights looking pretty good with the run game with Valentine, and then it just stalled. A little surprised, Greg, that with the situation at the end at the 43-yard line, not going for it on that fourth and three.
Yeah, I think right now what I'm thinking about and what has kind of turned the tides for this Cougar team, this Cougar offense, was first off that amazing 33-second drive, which, you know, was, I think, what was it, 60, 70 yards down the field?
65-yard drive, yeah.
Before the end of the first half. That, like, set them up for big momentum in the second half.
Out in the flat has Jackson looking for his tight end, Carter Minter, 6'2", 235, the Wake Forest native. He's a big target. If you're going to miss him, you've missed the broad side of the barn, because he's a big boy.
Yeah, and then the second play, as we just barely witnessed just about 15 minutes ago, was the, you know, pick six for the Cougars defense. Those two things, I think, has kind of really turned the tides for the Cougars, and they are definitely just controlling the game, the momentum, the flow of what's happening.
Third and 11 now with a five wide receiver set. The Knights get to forward pass. Underhand falls to the ground. It will not be a sack. Great job finding Grice. That was Isaiah Grice just kind of standing there with an underhand throw, but avoids the sack. First time the Knights have gotten real pressure on him in probably the last three series. Great job moving his feet. Jackson is a really good quarterback, plays aware with his head up. Good job avoiding the sack there. But the Knights hold him. Three and out, fourth and 11, on to punt. This is Mason Smith, a sophomore. Gets up a high punt. Wester calls for the fair catch at the 46-yard line. So the Knights now with great field position. Nearly 15 minutes left, 14 and 46 seconds in the fourth quarter. And we'll see what Pinkston can do. He will bring his team onto the field and try to orchestrate a touchdown drive here. They really need this. And I'll check that. They will bring in Shumway back in.
Yeah, if the Knights have any hope of coming back, they can't make any mistakes. Everything has need to be executed to perfection on both sides of the ball.
Four wide receiver set as Wester goes in motion. Hand off to Wood. As he goes off tackle to the left. He'll get two or three yards on the gain. Angel Medina, the senior wide receiver from West Valley, is in on this right side. And then a few of the usual suspects, Wester, Shank, and Pope over there on the left side. The defensive line for the Cougars has done a great job getting pressure, the four-man front line. They haven't had to bring many blitzes to get pressure. With some time, finding Pope. Pope now across the middle. After the catch, getting another 12 yards or so. Shumway did a good job rolling off the left. This time the offensive line doing a great job sealing off the backside, giving him a minute to set his feet, turn his shoulders, and find Pope on that curl route.
SVU, first down.
And then Pope with a great job running after the catch.
Yeah, the Cougar defensive line, I think, is making a huge impact on this game. Just like you said, Scotty, only bringing four basically every play, but still causing havoc in the backfield.
This time looking over the top, trying to find Johansson on that out and up route.
This is incomplete.
Sorry, that was Shank. That wasn't Johansson.
Heading for number six, Jake Shank.
Yeah, that was an impressive catch and run by Pope on the earlier catch. He's a 5'11", sorry, a 6'3", 180-pounder from Elk Creek, Virginia. Virginia native, but not many Virginia natives on this Southern Virginia team. Pope's one of them. Langtree takes that handoff, gets met immediately line of scrimmage. Able to get maybe a yard after getting met.
On the carry.
So it'll be third and 10.
No gain on the
probably 4 yard territory, four down territory here for the Knights. Wood will sub in for Langtree.
Yeah, I think if they have any hope to come back, yeah, they gotta try to put 7 points on the board.
So, leading receiver for the Knights, Skylar Johnson, in motion off to this right side. Man-to-man defense as pressure is put on Shumway, and he overthrows the out route for Johnson. There's really the pressure there. Again, only a four-man rush. And the pressure gets there, and Johnson's overthrown. He'd run a good route. He was open. But Shumway just not able to set his feet, leaning back and overthrowing. So the Knights now in a three-receiver set. Time in the middle, finding Troy. Troy catches the ball after he bobbles it, runs over the awaiting tackle of the defensive back, the safety senior, Dante Newfield. Fourth and 10, and Jalen Troy puts that ball in the end zone. The Danville native letting the local staff, the Danville boys of Averett, know they shouldn't have let him get away.
Yeah. And that makes 2 out of 2 on fourth down conversion, Scotty. Very efficient for the offense. Just playing a little joke. Definitely don't want to get to the fourth down, but it was a great, great execution. And that right there is what they're going to have to do for the rest of these 12 minutes and 26 seconds tonight on their start of this comeback.
All right, so 3 and out. And then they drive the length of the field, score a touchdown. Great job.
The Knights defense is going to have to replicate what the Cougar defense is doing by controlling the line of scrimmage, getting into the backfield with as minimal people as possible, but then downfield have the cornerbacks and the safeties be able to control and handle their matchups and not leave any soft spots. And if they can do that, they can put pressure on Jackson, contain these big threats that Jackson has downfield. The Knights defense can have another 3 and out, be able to put their offense back on the field.
Patrick Henry, the head coach for Averett, he's only been coaching. This is his first full season with the COVID nonsense that went on last year. But he's been an assistant since 2012 at Averett. He knows the lay of the land and the territory, the recruiting side. As this ball goes to Nixon, he's going to try and get another solid run back, or this time met and drop pretty quick at the 25-yard line. Coach Henry, he's also the quarterback's coach, and he's done a great job coaching Bryce Jackson. Jackson came into this competition today with 148 passing rating, 61% passing, 171 on 277 attempts with 20 TDs. Great job from Coach Henry putting together this offense. He'll need to pull out his best plays right now to get the momentum back and keep his offense on the field. Off tackle run by Big
tackle is
Phipps.
By number 99, Kimani, bye-bye.
Bye-bye there for the tackle. The Knights star defensive lineman. Back to number 99 after I think having two other numbers during the course of the season. Keeps ripping shirts and jerseys, and so the Knights have to keep ordering new jerseys for him.
Definitely garnering a lot of attention on the from the offensive linemen.
That is the out route. Great job on that back shoulder throw as Grice looked like he was going to go inside. Stops. Good timing in concert with his quarterback. Third down. Looks like it'll only be a yard, maybe two, for the first down. Big play for both teams. Fits in at tailback. We have Grice to the left and Nixon off to the right. And that's, I think it's Goffigan in the slot. Handoff goes up the middle. Gets across the 41, and that'll be enough for a first down. Solid run from the young running back, Bryce Phipps. Hard to stop 190 pounds when it's only 5'6". Big first down, time to bleed some more clock as Jackson will take the play clock all the way down. Under 10 seconds now. Nice bounce outside. Sewell having to make the tackle. Great job. It looked like Watlington was stopped in the backfield. Bounces that ball out wide. Watlington with 12 attempts and 51 yards. Great run from him to get 6 yards that looked like it was going to turn into to nothing. In motion, now getting to the outside again is Wallington. As he takes on the Knights defensive back. That was number 27, Cameron Whipple, the freshman. Also from Lake Jackson from Texas. Good job clearing the road there was Wesley Parker, the 245-pound tight end. Went in motion to that right side, and then did the road grader move, really creating space for Watlington. Now on the Knights side of the field, as Bryce Jackson hands off up the middle, Watlington battling, he'll get four. Just, he's an efficient runner, but the Knights are really, they're not getting penetration into the backfield. So he's getting to the line of scrimmage, being able to pick his hole, and then he'll get 4 yards on just about every run. He came in averaging 5.4 yards per carry. So very efficient runner. In now, though, in substitution is Bailey Bowen. Wesley Parker off the right. That's where they run. They run off the right side again. No. Yes, he does get there. Bowen. Apodaca chases him down.
Runners forced out of bounds.
Their best runs have been off that right side. Put Parker in. I mentioned earlier the Brock Lucas, the right tackle, senior, one of the leaders of that offensive line.
Yeah, big third down with just 8 minutes and about 30 seconds left of this game. The Knights can get a stop right here. That does give this team, this offense, time to get down, score, get the defense back on.
Trips to the left, five wide receiver set. Looking across the middle, through the hands of the waiting receiver. The target was Marquise Woodruff. He had one catch on the day for 7 yards. That would have been a huge catch. Not sure he would have had the first down. He was right at the marker. Either way, the ball slips through his fingers. And the punt team will come on for the Cougars. So a big stop for the Knights. Another opportunity. You mentioned 8 minutes, 20 seconds left. Clock is stopped. Down by 12. They'll need two touchdowns. Low snap, handled well. High punt, almost dies, lands at the 2-yard line and then goes in to the end zone. So result is a touchback. Ball come out to the 20-yard line. Knights putting a lot of pressure on that kick there.
They did a great job penetrating, just like you said, Scotty, getting back to the kicker after kind of a mishandled, but then good control by not hitting them, knowing that they were getting there too late.
Mason Smith, under duress, able to get off a solid kick that just barely goes into the end zone. He had players that were right underneath that ball. So the Knights come out again with Pinkston at the helm. Knights in a four receiver set as Huxford comes in motion. Pinkston finds Shank across the middle. Good patience. A three-man rush.
That is complete. Number six, Jake
from the front line of the Cougars, the offensive line did a great job holding off those three defensive linemen, giving Pinkston time to find Shank across the middle. He wanted to go to Huxford with that out route. Well covered from the communication from the defensive backs. Xavier Aguilar, nickel, steps up, did a great job communicating through that. Out route, finding Angel Medina.
Pinkston's pass is complete. Number 19, Angel Medina.
Pinkston is found.
Gain of 9 on the play, brings up second down and 1.
9 receivers today. 9 receivers have caught balls for Pinkston today.
Yeah, great catch by Medina. Would have probably liked him to see him actually turn to the outside to get out of bounds, stop the clock, instead of turning inside and getting no yards but keeping the clock running.
Stokes and Troy off to the left. Play action, looking for Skyler over the top. Skyler looked like he was going for maybe a back shoulder, and then that ball was up over the middle, and he tried to catch up to it, couldn't get there. Great job from Deontay Newfield in coverage. So, Huxford comes in, Francois Wester in the slot, and Medina out wide to the right. The shovel pass to Chase Wester. He's trying to get upfield. The transfer from BYU able to get the first down, keep the sticks moving. The clock moves under 7 minutes, but it is a first down. Great run from Wester as he stays in, as does Huxford. Matt Johansson comes out here wide to the right. Langtree's in it, running back. Four-man rush. Oh, that pass short and picked off. It's number 13, the defensive back, Jamal Ash. Did a great job sitting on that in zone. Not sure what Pinkston saw right there. He comes off talking to Coach Hughey. Looks like somebody ran the wrong route. There were two players really right next to each other. Looked like running deep routes for the Knights. Johansson on the right-hand side. Pinkston looked like he was expecting somebody to come inside on that.
Yeah, Pinkston definitely frustrated on the sideline. Unlucky, they were controlling the ball, getting the ball down the field. Now it's an even bigger uphill battle.
Out to Nixon. Nixon corralled. Good job from Darren Rice, the linebacker from North Carolina, Charlotte.
Darren Rice. Ball is spotted on the 45-yard line. No gain on the play. Brings up second down and 10.
Second and 10, no gain on that first down play. Fake handoff. Screen, wide receiver screen to Grice. Again, bringing him down is Darren Rice. Rice playing sideline to sideline right now.
Yeah, Darren Rice did a great job blowing up the man in front of him, which held up the runner and gave him an opportunity to break on the ball, make a
tackle. Trips to the field side. Goff again on the outside there with Grice inside in that bunch set on the right. Over there, great job finding his outlet there was Jackson as the blitz from Blake Hubert. Hubert comes in unblocked. Jackson did a great job circling out of that and then finding his outlet there. That was Sean Watlington just kind of hanging out. No gain on the play, but great job avoiding the sack. And they wasted, you know, a good solid 4 minutes on that. So the Knights now will have less than 4 minutes. Down by 12. There's a whistle. I don't know if they're going to call delay a game or if there's a timeout called.
We have delay a game.
They'll call delay a game.
Of the kicking team. That penalty is declined. The ball will start on a snap.
Now, ball at the 45-yard line declined. Goes to Coach Mulitalo, the penalty. Wanting to give as much opportunity for that ball to be a touchback as possible. Knights try to get there. Don't get there. Another solid kick. But the kick team not able to get there to cover it as Mason Smith kind of looks to the sky. Again, dropped that in a great spot. But unlucky for him as it rolls into the end zone. So the Knights now, 3:56 left, Greg. Down by 12. They moved the ball very effectively on that last drive, but it took them a while. They don't have that kind of time now.
Yeah, with Shumway coming out, having two interceptions on the day, I don't know, it seems kind of like a wild card, but he does have the ability to put together some amazing passes, just like he did with hitting Skyler, so we'll see how well they execute.
And Shumway hands off to Valentine. Valentine gets 5 yards on the run.
Matthew Valentine on the carry.
They don't have much time for this. They're going to have to do hurry up.
Gain of 6 on the play.
Not sure this is the time necessarily for run plays. I mean, this is definitely a winnable game. 4 wide receivers. Quick out route. But Shumway just rushed that. Didn't get his feet set, short on the pass.
6, Jake Shank.
He had Shank running that quick out route, sort of a wide receiver screen. Nelson comes in. He's a very sure blocker. He'll have, Shumway will have Wester, Chase Wester and Huxford in the slots with Johnson and Pope split out wide. 3-man rush, ball hits the ground. Chase finds Pope, turns and runs upfield. Pope will get the first down. It'll stop the clock as they move the sticks. See if the Knights are in hurry up here.
Ball is spotted on the 47-yard line.
Yeah, again, great reception, great run after the ball, but you got to get out of bounds instead of getting tackled. You got to stop the clock.
Cougars go to a three-man rush again. Eight in defense. Skylar Johnson across the middle. Won't get the first down. That'll keep the goal. He will get the first down. Just barely gets the first down, which stops the clock.
First down.
Under 3 minutes. Knights with trips to the right. Skylar Johnson split out wide to the left. This time a five-man rush. A blitz comes in up to Johnson. Johnson didn't look like he thought the ball was coming his way. He didn't go hard on that route.
Complete intended for number 11, Skylar Johnson. Brings up second down and 10.
Love to see him work a little harder on that route.
Yeah, I think Terrell England was looking for a second interception on the day.
Langtree comes in substitution in the backfield. He's a very good blocker. Zone. Defense. Shumway looking. He's just going to put the ball down, run out of bounds. He'll get
Fulton Shumway on the keeper.
Looks like maybe two or 3 yards on the run.
Ball spotted on the 40-yard line.
Clock starts again until it gets under 2 minutes. We'll restart even when the runner goes out of bounds. So now trips to the field side. Francois Woodson to the boundary. Here on the right. Roll out to his left. Shumway's looking. Great job coming back for that ball. The shank. They're going to say, though, that he step out of bounds before he caught it?
One ref was signaling incomplete, but.
There's your timeout from injury.
Yeah, it's going to be 4th and 8. Good job coming to that ball with Shank. They're just saying that he was out of bounds when he caught it, I think, because I do think he caught it. There's a Cougar down on the field. He gets up, pops right up. That was defensive lineman number 94, Javon Lofton, the senior. 5'11", 295 from Salisbury, North Carolina. Good to see him pop up. So this is really the game right here. I mean, the Knights still have a lot of work to do, even if they get this first down. But if they don't get this first down, that'll be the game. Shumway has Huxford, Wester, and the senior Angel Medina off to the left. Again, rolling out to the left. Finding Medina coming back. They're saying he caught it. And enough for the first down. Great job by Medina coming back to that ball and getting his arms underneath the pass.
First down.
Shumway does a great job rolling out to his left, turning his shoulders. Right-handed thrower. Does a good job on that. Roll out to the left, though. Four-man rush. Quick out route to Huxford. He has a chance to get out of bounds, and he does.
Pass is complete. Number 13.
Jamal Ash on the tackle. And there's a timeout called.
Timeout, Averett.
Averett calls a timeout, wants to get their men together. Figure out exactly what they're going to do here. So minute 26 left, down by 12. You're going to need to get a touchdown, Greg, and then get yourself an onside kick, and that'll give you a chance.
Yeah, it's great to see the Knights moving the ball down the field. It has been definitely, I think, lopsided to the Cougars this second half, but the Knights making something happen right here, and which is making it exciting.
Come on, come on, come on. Oh, Huxford picking up that first down. First and 10 from the 17. Knight staying in this four receiver set with Jacob Wood in the backfield. Over the middle to Shank. Nice find by Shumway. Threading the needle between three Cougars.
Number six, Jake Shank.
Knight's now down by six. Still need a touchdown, even if this extra point is good. Bass will come in. And the extra point is good. So, solid comeback by the Knights, getting these two touchdowns. Put themselves in a position. The Knights now with 24 first downs on the day compared to 19 for Averett. Four of 13 on third down. Really solid play the last two drives. 407 total yards for the Knights compared to 347 for Averett. Kind of a common theme. The Knights often can move the ball, end up with solid rushing and passing yards, but often trailing where it counts on the scoreboard, Greg.
Yeah, that was a great last drive for the Knights offense. 80 yards, just about a minute and a half of a drive. This onside kick is definitely going to come down to it, because if they can repeat what they just did, that they do have enough time to make it happen again.
Yeah, all three timeouts. They went, as you said, 80 yards, 3 minutes, 56-second drive, 10 plays. So they can move the ball. We'll see what Derek Bass and Coach Hugie, who's the special teams coordinator. Bass puts it down. He gets the bounce. Oh, but a great job. That was number five, Terrell England.
The onside kick is
going up and grabbing that thing. He gets plastered. I think that was Wester who came across the top trying to dislodge the ball. And showing a lot of courage there was England. And now minute 21, the Knights have three timeouts, so they can force a punt with the ball on the 48-yard line.
Yeah, the Cougars just need to, I think, get at least one first down.
Wallington getting outside. He gets a solid 4 yards on the run. Again, good job from the left side of the offensive line for the Cougars. Usually they've run off that right side, but this time running behind Matthew Isom, the sophomore. He's 6'6", 275 from Bedford. That's not a bad man to run behind.
That's a buddy you take out to dinner and thank him for leading the way.
Yeah, you do. In the NFL, that's the dude you buy the Rolex for.
Keep doing what you're doing, I'll get you whatever you want.
All right, sorry. He's at center right now, is Matthew Isom. Again, Wallington trying to bounce it outside. A bevy of Cougars join the party for that tackle. Dallin Breen.
By number 21, Nate Mattis.
Nate Mattis in there, along with Jason Ciosi. So minute 9, 3rd and 5. Knights with one more timeout. They could get this ball back with about 45 seconds left. 40 seconds left. They probably have like 55 seconds. They'll get a timeout on this next one. So just under a minute the Knights could have to go down if they can stop the Cougars on this third and five play.
Well, every play matters, but right now this is the biggest third down of the game.
When they down brain in with Kamani Vaivai. Along with Logan Mullen playing left tackle, defensive tackle. Hand off up the middle, trying to get to the outside. Shut down. The Knights will call timeout immediately. A minute two left, fourth and call it three or four. So fourth and three, ball on the 41-yard line. They could go for this, but you know, with a minute left, by the time you kick it, it'll be about 55 seconds. You got to try to force the Knights to go the length of the field.
Yeah, and they're getting close to getting that punt right in the, you know, within 10 yards, 5 yards of, you know, the Knights' own, you know. So they can pin him down. They're getting close to be able to, you know, execute that punt.
Yeah, Mason Smith, this will be his third attempt to try and pin the Knights inside the 20. Chase Lester goes back, puts his heels on the 10-yard line. Usually they're instructed, if that, put your heels on the 10, and if it's going to go over your head, you let it go. Smith back to kick. Knights block the kick! And it goes out of bounds. The Knights unable to recover, but the block kick from Jason Ciosi. They had come close a couple times. This time Ciosi gets through. Ciosi finds the ball with that right hand. And that ball will be at the, I think, the 41-yard line. Well, it'll be at the 36. 36-yard line.
57 seconds to travel 36 yards. Definitely in the wheelhouse for the Knights offense.
On senior day, Colton Shumway, the sophomore, brings out this Knights offense. He showed some great composure in the last two drives. We'll see what Coach DePay has in store. This time a rollout, this has been very effective. Almost gets tackled before he throws it. On the chase there with the defensive tackle, Jonathan Terrell. The 5'8", 260-pounder from Sanford, North Carolina, was flying in there. Shumway, a business major, a four-year veteran, football, wrestling, and baseball. He's out of, mentioned, Enoch, Utah, Canyon View High School. Definitely an athlete. Right over the top of the linebacker. That was almost intercepted by number two, the linebacker, Nicholas Mintz, the senior. Third and 10, 49 seconds left.
It's like number 70 for the Knights is down.
Yeah, that's the offensive lineman, Bryce Lambert, the freshman from Haymarket, Virginia. Rain starts to come down a little bit here in Buena Vista. Thank you. Paul Tobias out there, the head athletic trainer for the Knights football team, tending to Lampert. The 10-second runoff does not count. I've heard some fans yelling for the 10-second runoff, but it doesn't count if the clock is stopped. So because of the incomplete pass, the clock was stopped. So there is no 10-second runoff for the injury.
Here comes another big third down.
Third down for the Knights. Shumway rolls out to the right. Gets a pass off. Incomplete. Couldn't really find an open receiver. He had Shank open on the right side. Couldn't find him. Now, another fourth down for the Knights. Well, this is what you wanted, Gray. This is what you thought. They're 3-for-3 on fourth down, so your strategy comes into play.
I know. Right now, I'm not really feeling like a betting man, though, but they got it. I mean, this is definitely what you got to do. Be in this position, down by five.
So all three plays in this drive, the Knights have had rollouts for Shumway. It's a four-man rush. He doesn't roll out this time. Steps up. He's going to try and get the first down. He gets the first down. He's still on his feet. Gets to the 15-yard line. The clock rolls paused for the sticks to set. Shumway steps up. He's going to ask. They're going to get into the down the ball quickly set. Great play by the sophomore. Gets the ball to the 15-yard line.
Hey, you brought it up earlier, the composure of Shumway. Making some mistakes earlier in the game, but staying level-headed, you know, putting the pass in the past, not letting it affect him. And again, just like you said, great play, great recognition. No open options downfield, going for the first down marker and getting more.
Yeah, his athleticism. He's a wrestler in high school, a four-year letterman in wrestling. And he's a tough kid. He knows how to get things done. This time he has time. Out route, tipped. I can't tell. They're going to call pass interference, but if the ball was tipped before it got to Shank, it will be in the end zone, which put the ball at the one-yard line. If the ball was tipped before it gets to Shank, then there's going to be no pass interference.
The pass was tipped, so there's no defensive pass interference.
So second and 11.
Second down.
Third and 11 because of the downed play. 25 seconds left. The Knights can get a first down. Ball on the 16. Shrink goes in motion. Cougars will be in a zone set. Two high safeties. Ball up the middle of the road. He's still on his feet. Driving. He's at the goal line. It is a first down, so clock stops. Flags fly, laundry all over the field. This will be a huge call. It stops the clock, the flags do. The play was done. This is a huge play right here.
After the play is over, we have unsportsmanlike conduct, number 65 in offense, for the player off the call. There's a 50-yard penalty.
Wow, it was going to be first and goal from the 1 yard line with 19 seconds left. And they call a unsportsmanlike on the Knights. I think they'll just down this ball real quick. So it'll be Second and 10 with 17 seconds left. I didn't see what happened, Greg. Did you see what happened?
I didn't, but you've mentioned before the young experience with the O-line for the Knights, and it's just something that you learn either by, trial and error or, by watching other people. You just can't pull off other players off of the pile.
Rolling out to the right is Shumway. He's got time. Throws the ball out of bounds, looking for Wester. Third and 10 from the 17. He had a minute there. He's getting chased. They're only rushing three, dropping eight. We're the Cougars' defense there. 11 seconds, so there's time enough for two plays, but you can't get tackled inbounds. You have to get out of bounds. No first down available. It's third and goal from the 17 for the Knights. No, they can get a first down. I guess because of the penalty, they can get a first down at the 4-yard line. Looking across the middle, he goes up. Two players come down with it. And they're going to call it an interception as Wester tries to pull the ball loose. Another flag flies. So we'll wait to see what this call is.
With the ball, came down first, touching the ground, and it's Averett's ball, first and 10. Play, with unforced conduct, number one of Averett, we have the distance to go.
So
that's number one, first unsportsmanlike like in the game.
Well, that was an incredible drive. And an opportunity for the Knights. You got to love the heart and the grit that Shumway showed. That first down and then that call, the play call for the inside handoff to Wood that got to the 1-yard line. That was incredible as well. Gutsy call by Dupay and almost paid off. And then now the victory formation as Averett will take a knee. Great game by both teams. The Knights have one more game left. Averett has two. The Knights will be away. Gotta love this opportunity for the Knights and the Cougars to come together and show some fantastic football. Looking over the stats for the game. The Knights end up going for 441 yards with 300 yards passing between Shumway and Pinkston. Also 141 yards rushing. One of the best offensive outputs for the Knights all year long. Only gave up one sack. Averett ends up 350 yards, 231 yards passing, which is under their season average, well under their season average. The Knights doing a really good job. I thought in the first half it was about to get out of control when they had that, as you mentioned, the last drive of the first half, and then the first drive of the second half was fantastic. But then the Knights clamped down, and they forced a three and out. They really pushed Averett right to the brink, and they had the ball first and goal with 90 seconds left on the 1-yard line to go up by 2 points. They were down by five, could have gone up by two. So, I thoroughly enjoyed this game. I thought it was well played by both teams, both quarterbacks doing a great job, Shumway and Jackson.
Yeah, definitely could have been a little different of a turnout if that, that penalty didn't come from pulling the guy off the pile. That's just really, really unlucky, but it happens. And like you said, Scotty, I think overall it was like a really fun game. It was awesome to see the Knights you know, come back after, you know, the Cougars offense just, you know, controlled the game and just asserted their dominance on the field. And then just, yeah, to see the Knights continue to rally, you know, like you mentioned many times, the family, that attitude of culture of, you know, being with your brothers, playing all 60 minutes. It was really awesome to see the Knights defense. And it's something that we haven't seen a whole lot this season, so it's awesome to see that they are finally, you know, playing those 60 minutes together, never giving up, and great things as we saw happen. And without that one penalty, you know, it could have been easily a night victory.
Yeah, Shumway comes in, the sophomore, in relief of Pinkston. He's 13 for 26, 197 yards, 3 TDs. Unfortunately, he did have 2 interceptions. Pinkston was 10 for 20 with 89 yards. Valentine, the senior, 9 rushes, 52 yards, 5.8 per rush, well above the Knights' season average of 3.3. Jake Schenck led all receivers for the Knights with 61 yards on 4 receptions. Looking over the stats for the Cougars, Jackson was 19 for 28 with 231 yards, 2 TDs, and an interception. Wallington, 17 rushes, 75 yards, 4.4 yards per rush. Isaiah Grice, 99 yards on 10 receptions. And Nixon with 81 yards on 5 receptions. I thought the Knights did a great job shutting down Nixon in the second half. He was really tearing the Knights up in the first half. He did end up with 16 yards per reception and a TD. But the Knights doing a much better job on him. Grice, solid all game long, leading all receivers with 99 yards. So an impressive game from Jackson and this Cougar crew and Coach Henry and what he brought in coming up from Danville. The Knights, something to build on for sure. They're going to want to get a win in their last game of the season, but Coach Muritalo definitely building on what he had last year, and I think they're really going to enjoy being in this USA South Conference. A little note, this is the last season for the Cougars in the USA South. They have accepted an invitation to be part of the ODAC. So they will join the Old Dominion Athletic Conference next season in football. We really appreciate everybody joining us for this game this afternoon. We mentioned 5 p.m. come back and watch the Knights women's soccer team host their first playoff game in school history. We hope everybody has a safe and a successful travel home if you're going home from the Knights Stadium. God bless and good evening.